Hello everyone. Today video session is for class 8 for students. Topic chapter is seeing MS Access. Today first topic is primary key. So first the definition and then I will explain you in a simple way. Primary key is a field which uniquely identify individual records in a table. For example, admission number may be a primary key in a student's data table. Now, what is primary key and why we have to set primary key? Actually, in database, when we create a table, then that table contains lot of information in it. So, it is very difficult to find or to search any information. Because of that, we take one of the field in such a way which contain different value for every record or unique value for every record. Take this example. In a school, there are thousands of the students. Now, for example, we want to get information about any child. So, if we are searching the information according to the name, so it may be possible that there are many students which are having the same name. So, it will become a problem. Because of this, we have to use admission number. Because in a school, every child is having different admission number. And with the help of admission number, information can be searched easily. Now, again, I am saying the definition. Now, it will be clear to you. Primary key is a field which uniquely identify individual records in a table. Okay? So, means when we set any field as a primary key, it accepts only the unique values. Even if by mistake, we enter the same value again, that value will not be accepted. So it contains error message will display on the screen. After this, then the next topic is switching views. MS Access allows different views to work with the data. Switching from one view to the other is quite convenient. Though there are four views, but two of them are very much in use, that is data sheet view and design view. Generally we use these views. So I will explain you about these two views in detail. Now the next is first switching views. Then how we have to change the views? If you are working in data sheet view and you want to switch to the design view or to any other view, then the process is this. In MS Access, first you have to click on the home button, then there is a view button. And when we click on the downhanded arrow of the view button, then all the four views will be shown to you and then you can select the required one. The next topic is data sheet view. Data sheet view allows to enter the values in the form of rows and column. It display in the form of rows and column. This view is generally used for entering and correcting the values. Please remember, the value have to be entered only in data sheet view, not in any other view. So this view is especially used for entering the values. And yes, if you have to make any correction, then you have to switch to the data sheet view, only then the corrections can be made. The next is design view. Design view, as the name is design view, means this view is used to design the structure of the table. This view contains two parts. This top portion is known as field entry area. Field entry area means here you have to enter field name, data type and description. This description is optional. If you want to write down some information about the field name, then you can write down it over here. This topic was already explained by the teacher, so I'm not going in detail. Only this much I'm telling you. This view is known as design view. It is used to create the design the structure of the table. It consists of two parts. This top portion is known as the field entry area and this bottom portion is known as the field properties area. About this, you will learn in detail in the next chapter. After this, the next topic is setting a primary key. Then, if you want to set any field as a primary key, first you have to see that which field can be set as a primary key. Now, for example, right now you can see a table which is open in the data sheet view. This table contains different fieldings like admission number, name, houses and age. Now, first I am taking age. Can we set age as a primary key? No, we can't set, because in a class there will be many students, those who are from the same age group. So it is not possible. Can we set houses? No, that is also not possible, because in a class the students are divided only in four houses. So it must be repeated. So that is also not possible. The next is name of the student. Can we set it as a primary key? No, not again, because in the class it may possible that the two of the students are having the same name. Now admission number, yes, can we set this as a primary key? Yes, it can be set, because every child is having a different admission number. Now I will explain you how to set a primary key. For setting a primary key, first you have to switch to the design view. Click on the home tab, then view button, and then select the option design. When you switch to the design view, then there is a key type icon. It is written here primary key. So first you have to select the field to which you want to set as a primary key. Here I want to set admission number as a primary key. So just bring the cursor here and click. Now this field is selected. Means now whatever the formatting will be applied, it will be applied to this field only. So after selecting it, click on the primary key icon. Now here you will notice that a small icon of the key will display over here. Means now the admission number is set as a primary key. By mistake, if you have set a wrong primary key, then you can remove it also. Step will same, just select it by clicking over it and click on the primary key icon. This area is known as field selector. This area is used for selecting field. For example, as I'm clicking on age, so age is selected now. Now I want to select admission number again, so admission number is selected now. Now the second method for setting a primary key, right click on this field to which you want to set as a primary key and select the option primary key. So primary key will set again, and this field will set again as a primary key. So here now admission number is set as a primary key. Now the next topic is entering data in data sheet view. So here I have set this field as a primary key. After this I am changing the view. Then computer is asking that I want to save the changes of this table. I said yes, I want to save the changes. So again I am back in this data sheet view. In this data sheet view, one more advantage is there of setting a primary key, that all these values are arranged in ascending order automatically. Okay, means whatever the values was entered in the primary key field will automatically be arranged in ascending order. So next topic is entering data. If you want to enter any data, you just click in the particular field where you want to enter the data, and then for moving to the next field you have to press the tab key, so it will be shifted to the tab next field. So here I am entering the values. Now for example, house is yellow for a child, age is 13. This way, here you will see that there is a small pencil type icon, means this is the current record. Means right now I am entering the value in this, and here towards the bottom we are having this asterisk sign, means this is the new record. Now for entering the values here, just click in the field, write down the information whatever you want, and then use the tab key to move to the next field. In this way the information may be entered. After doing this, you just have to click on the save icon for saving this table. If the name is already given, the changes will be saved. Otherwise, the save as dialog box will display on the screen for giving a name to the table. Now the next topic is changing data. Changing, or you can say updating data. Sometimes it happens that the table which we have created, there are some mistakes in it. And we want to correct those mistakes, or sometimes we want to delete some information from there, or we want to add some new information, then what we have to do. So first topic in this is add a new record. For example, I want to add one new record. So adding a new record is very simple. You just have to click and start typing. Now for example, I want to add a new record in between. For this purpose, I have to select the particular place where I want to add a new record. After this, then click the mouse right button on it and then select the option new record. This way, new record will be inserted. But here you will notice that it is new record is inserting only at the bottom, because this is a primary key and every record will automatically be arranged in ascending order. You just have to simply press the tab key and the new record will be entered. Now here I am entering. Now just to explain to you, I am just entering only number 1, 2, 3, 4 I have entered. So after saving this table, you can see this value. This record will be displayed at the top because here I have entered only 1, 2, 3. So house is blue and age is 12 I have entered. I am saving this table and I am closing it now. After closing the table, I am opening the table once again. And then you can see now this record is there at the top. So if you want to add a new record, you just have to just click automatically new record button is given. Means this is a new record. Just click it over here, enter the value and one blank record will be displayed at the bottom. The next is add a new column. If you want to add a new column, then what are the steps you have to follow? Now for example, there are four columns, that is admission number, name of the students, class, houses and age. In between now here I want to add one blank column. So first I have to come to the field name, then right click over here and then select the option insert field. Then one blank column will be inserted to the left of the selected column. Okay, new column is inserted at the left of the selected column. The next is updating a record. Updating a record is very simple. Now for example, here by mistake I have entered age 12. So I want to change it. Then just click it over here and then make the correction. For example, this was 13. So in this way we can update it. Now for example, here the name of the child is written Saad. I just want to write down the complete name like Saad Ansari. So I just have to click it over here and then I can make the correction. In this way the corrections are made. After this, the next one topic is deleting a row or column. Now for example, this record I'm not having the complete information of this child, so I want to delete this record. So first click to the record selector. This sidebar is called the record selector. Just click it over here, the entire record is get selected. Okay, I'm just doing it, showing you again like this. Then right click over here and select the option delete record. This then confirmation dialog box will be displayed on the screen, that if you are sure, then you have to delete one record or whatever the records are selected. Then click on the button yes and that particular record will be deleted. Now here I had inserted one blank field over here. Now I want to delete this field. Then deleting the field, come to the field header, then right click over here, then select the option delete field. So this field will be deleted. Confirmation dialog box will surely be displayed. Select the option and that particular field will be deleted. I hope all these topics will be clear to you. Bye. Okay students, now the assignment. Question number 1, define primary key. Question number 2, define data sheet view and design view. Question number 3, write down the steps to delete row and column in a table. Thank you.